everyone. Welcome back to Today in Tech. I'm Juliet Beauchamp, and I'm here with Jack Gold, the principal analyst and president of J.Duck Gold Associates. And today we are talking about network slicing. So, Jack, take it away. What exactly is network slicing?
Thanks, Juliet. Look, network slicing is something that I think a lot of people don't understand. And it's going to be a critical capability for 5G going forward. There's some of it available in 4G today, but mostly it's going to be critically available, critical capability in 5G, and here's why. Imagine a network, the full bandwidth of a network that's available, and you've got thousands of users trying to access that bandwidth. Not all users need the full bandwidth. If I'm streaming a 4K video gaming system, then yeah, I need tons and tons of bandwidth. If I'm sending a text, all I need is a few kilobytes. That's the whole, maybe not even that much. That's the whole thing. Maybe it's just a few bytes. And so the problem is that the network operators want to make sure that they give everyone the best possible experience they can on their networks. And the way you do that is not to give people that are texting the full network bandwidth for however long it takes to text, because that will take, 3 seconds out of somebody's gaming experience and there'll be a glitch. Rather, what they're going to do is they're going to take the full bandwidth of the network and cut it into slices. So if I have a text that I need to send, and that text is just a few kilobytes at best, then I'm going to give you a few kilobytes worth of data capability on that network. Let's say, use an example, making this up. Let's say the bandwidth available is 100 megabytes. It'll probably be more than that, but 100 is a nice round number. So if you're a gamer, I may give you 75, 80, 85 megabits of that data bandwidth. And if you're a texter, I may give you 75 or 80 kilobits of that data. Now I can satisfy you and the gamer, and I can satisfy a whole bunch more texters. And then if you're doing something that is web searching, I can satisfy a bunch of people there because I can slice the network for the needs that they have. And what this means to the carriers is two things. One, I can give you a better experience, but two, I can also potentially charge a premium price. If you're a gamer and you want all that bandwidth and you're cutting other people out, then I'm going to charge you more than if you're a texter. Or let's say you're an IoT device, you're a meter. This is a great example, actually, where this is real, where you're talking about bytes of data maybe once a week or once a month. I'm going to slice the network capability for you so that I can charge you, maybe it's $1 a month, maybe it's less, because I don't have to charge you for a full, $50, $70, $80 a phone charge to get that meter data out there because there's such small data. So network slicing works because it gives everyone kind of equal access to the network based on their needs. Now, the only way this works, by the way, and here's why it hasn't been a big deal, hasn't been used in the past very much, is the only way it works is with the new network cores. The core is the technology that makes the network work behind the scenes, behind the radio towers. And in the past, that's all been kind of dedicated equipment. Here's a switch, here's a router, here's a radio, here's whatever it is. We're moving now to something that's called NFV, Network Function Virtualization, which basically uses standard computers with a few accessories tied onto their, USB ports. They're faster than USB ports, perhaps. And you can program them to do whatever you need to do. So I can then program the core of the network to give Juliet 80% of the bandwidth and Jack 8% of the bandwidth, because that's all they're using right now, and I can adjust it accordingly as needed. So that's really why slicing is so important. And it's going to be a big deal for 5G. It's going to be a big deal for users as well from a performance and security perspective.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Jack, for letting us know. This is really insightful information. Really appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you.
And thank you all so much for watching this episode of Today in Tech. If you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions about network slicing, be sure to leave a comment below. I'll get back to you on Jack's behalf. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time.